What if you woke up tomorrow in a world and in a life that only included things that you were grateful for today? That means if you're not grateful for it today, tomorrow it won't be there. What would you be grateful for? Now think about what I just said, because this was a post that was shared by my friend, Dr. Saliha Afridi. She's a friend of the podcast. I don't do this often, but if you haven't heard of Dr. Saliha Afridi, she's a clinical psychologist, a great woman. But most important of all, when you're using social media and if you're following people, it's important to follow people that add value to you, especially in times of turmoil, especially with all the noises that's out there. You want to be able to follow someone that makes you think, that enables you to go through your thoughts and hopefully come out of it a better person. And I get that every time I see a post by Dr. Saliha Afridi. I'm gonna place the link below. Make sure you follow her. Make sure you check out her posts. But this was a post that made me literally stop what I was doing. And I sat down and I actually did this. And I'm sharing this with you in the hope that it will affect you and you end up doing something with it to find peace and to be happy in the moment. Not for tomorrow, in the moment. I'll read the quote again. What if you woke up tomorrow morning in a life and in a world that only included things that you were grateful for today? Think about this. Tomorrow can only have the things that you are grateful for today. I literally stopped what I was doing. No kidding. I literally stopped what I was doing. I actually said it. Wow, I practice gratitude and I'm a loudspeaker for it. It's true. But this question, in its specificity has me thinking that I must sit down right now and write it down. I literally said exactly what I'm telling you. I literally just stopped everything and I sat down and I wrote it. I'm gonna share with you just a part of what I shared on social media, and then the list just kept going on my computer where I was just typing out all the things. Come think about it. Tomorrow, you won't have anything that you're not grateful for today. So I'm like, hey, there is a lot of things that I'm grateful for today, no matter what the situation is, but pay attention. I wrote so much. It just kept on going, but I shared a bit of it on social media and I thought I'll share it with you because it made me realize and appreciate to be happy and to be grateful for the moment, regardless of whatever the situation is. Understand, I travel 300 days of the year. I speak as a motivational speaker and as a public speaking coach, shadowing royalty, presidents, politicians, leaders, which means my business is traveling. And for the last 3 months, all the planes are grounded, which means my business is zero. Zero. So it's easy to complain. This is what I wrote. Again, I'm sharing this with you in the hope that it will help you find peace, for you to do this exercise, and also for you to find the happiness in the little things that you already have. I wrote, I'm grateful for my family. Grateful that they are happy, healthy, and safe. I'm grateful that we have a good relationship with each other. I'm grateful for their presence. I'm grateful for their laughs. I'm grateful to have woken up today. I'm grateful to be in Dubai. I'm grateful that I can step out into the sun. I'm grateful for coffee. If you know me, you know that rings true. I am grateful for the good, healthy food I get to consume every day. I am grateful for the knife and chopping board that brings me peace. It's true. I'm a professional chopper. That's what I like to do. I say cook healthy, but I don't cook very much. I just chop vegetables, put it together, and make good food. I'm grateful for it. That feeling, it's so nice. I'm grateful for Netflix. This is not a promo, but it's true. I'm grateful for all the colors that I see. I'm grateful for my taste buds. I'm grateful for my insatiable appetite. It's true, because a few months ago, I had food poisoning and I couldn't even eat for like 3 days. The moment I could actually eat properly, which took 5 days, if you know me, this is serious. 5 days of not being able to eat. People knew I was sick because I was refusing food and coffee. You know there is something wrong with me if I'm refusing food and coffee. And after that, it made me realize I'm so grateful for my appetite. I'm grateful for dancing. Oh, I miss dancing, but I'm grateful to have been able to dance and hopefully be able to dance. Just the thought of it, I'm grateful to be able to have the thoughts and the memories of dancing. I'm grateful that I can have my time to think. In a world where everyone has been so busy, I've always been blessed for the last decade or two. I may not have had a lot of things, but I've had plenty of time to think. I am where I am today because I've been able to think, to reflect. I have the peace. I'd like to think I have a bit of wisdom because I've had the ability and the time to process a lot of thoughts. I'm grateful for that. Yeah, and I just said, wow, I wrote so many things down, and none of which, and this is the point of the whole video, none of which has touched on things that I actually like business, money, or success. Isn't that interesting? So going back to the quote, what if you woke up tomorrow in a world or in a life where all you had that was included was the things that you were grateful for today? Be grateful. Beyond that, take a moment, turn everything off, start writing down, what are you grateful for? I believe that in the process of writing this, in the process of you realizing this, and as you're reading it, you will realize how blessed you are, how important it is to be grateful. And I hope, like me, and I'm sure thousands of others, through the process, you find happiness today.